Thursday, March 3rd, 2011. The time now is 10:07 a.m. Temperature is 24.7 degrees Fahrenheit, minus 4.1 degrees Celsius. The pond is frozen. There looks like there's some footprints on it from day camp last week during the Ann Arbor Public Schools winter break. And this week I am joined from some students from Ann Arbor Learning Community who are here participating in a week of Annie's Big Nature Lesson here at the Leslie Science and Nature Center. Today we're going to go to the pond, chip some holes in the ice, and see what organisms we can find and do some chemical testing of the water. Very cool. Let's go. Looking down at the ice, I see air bubbles in the ice. So if you look closely, you'll see the tiny little air bubbles where the footprints are. All right, today our students helped us chip this hole in the ice. We discovered that my measurement stick went down at least 125 centimeters. We could not access the mud even with our core sample because it was just too wet. The mud would not adhere to the core sample. Thank you, Mr. Alex in the red hat. Show us the core sample after your picture. Now, question. What was the temperature of the water?
0 degrees Celsius.
0 degrees Celsius, right there, right at the freezing melting point of water. What was the pH, please?
Six.
What was the phosphate?
That was a one.
What?
One.
Phosphate was a one. What was the nitrate? So phosphate, one part per billion. Nitrate was?
Five
parts per million. How about the dissolved oxygen?
Four.
Yeah?
It was 4 ppm.
4 parts per million. And turbidity? Yeah? 80 turbidity. Now, who remembers what that smelled like? Everybody, give me a verbal representation of how the pond water smelled. So how did the pond water smell? Go! All right. Now, without saying a word, without using words, I want you to tell me how the pond smelled.
Expressions?
Just you can make noise but no words. Ready, set, go. It smelled bad. The smell you're smelling, ladies and gentlemen, is a sulfury smell. It's caused by the decaying leaves. Look around. There's no leaves on the trees. All of these trees have lost their leaves, which have fallen in the pond and are starting to rot. In fact, remember, this pond was caused by a glacier. Look around, the glacier stopped right here, and it dropped a big ice cube, plop, right there. And the ice cube melted, and all the sediment came out of that ice and made this bowl here. So the rain and the water fill this pond up, and the snow fills it up in the ice, and then when it melts, the pond only has that water. And then if we have a really dry summer, the pond dries up quickly. And if we have a wet summer, the water lasts through fall. So this is what they call a vernal pond because it's thickest in the spring, deepest in the spring. And I guarantee by the end of the month, there will be one night, a warm, rainy night, when all of the salamanders in the woods come down to this pond. They all come down and they dance in the pond. And it's weird. Now, how in-depth do we need to go with this? Let's just say that the salamanders all come down here and they dance. The boys are dancing and they're attracting the females. The females see a fancy dancing boy and they can smell the pheromones given off by the boy and they say, hey, you look attractive. And they fertilize the eggs and it goes on from there. You can find out about it when you see the Pondcast from last March. Now, boys and girls, also, this pond, 14,000 years of sediment. These plants and bodies of animals and bugs have been falling in here. I don't think there's any mastodons in here, but that would be really cool. But all the plants, all the bugs, and all the insects. We've got 14,000 year layer of sediment here. That is really cool. So when we stuck the stick in 1.25 meters, 125 centimeters, that was probably not even touching the bottom layer of the sediment that's in here. That is so cool. Question.
Can you go scuba diving in here and start digging in the
sediment? What somebody a few years back, maybe 20 years ago, 15 years ago, somebody put on waders. Cheryl Somm and Bill Casello. And they put on waders, and they waded out here, and they got chest deep in muck. And it was just mucky all the way down. So if you scuba dived, you'd only have maybe 20 centimeters, 30 centimeters of water. So it'd really be kind of boring. Best thing to do would be to take a kayak out.
Yeah.
That's what I hope to do someday. All right, any other questions, comments, concerns, queries?
Confessions.
No. Oh, no confessions. Yes. Yes.
The snow is terrible.
The snow is terrible. All right.